How, when, and where. Change is the only constant factor in the universe. Nothing is static in this world. There is always a continuous change in the social, economic, and cultural life of the people living in different parts of the world. As we embark upon a journey from times immemorial, we will notice that several of our present practices and beliefs have undergone a change from those of the ancient and medieval times. You may even ask yourself, when and how? History helps us to answer such questions as it records the developments which brought about these changes. History is certainly about changes that occur over a period of time. It is about finding out how things were in the past and how things have changed. Importance of dates. We take things for granted as if what we see has always been in the world we inhabit. But most of us have our moments of wonder when we ask questions that are related to history. For instance, watching someone drinking coffee, we may often wonder, when did people begin drinking coffee? All such questions pertaining to the history take us to the realm of time. But it will be actually incorrect to fix any precise dates to processes that happen over a period of time. People in India did not begin drinking coffee suddenly one fine morning. They must have developed a taste for it over a period of time. There cannot be certain or particular date for a process such as this. Being a continuous flow of the events, history cannot be divided into compact compartments. Date of events act somewhat like milestones as they indicate an event's position in relation to other events in history. This helps us to understand the trends of developments within a time frame. Some dates and events act as a landmark because of their long-term impact. For example, the year 1857 is a landmark in Indian history, not only because it represents the first war of Indian independence, but also because it is the year in which the rule of East India Company came to an end and the British government took direct control over the Indian administration. The dates around which we compose our story of the past are not important on their own. They become vital because we focus on a particular set of events as important. If our focus of study changes, a new set of dates will appear as being significant. Thus, the importance of dates depends on the aspect from which history is studied. Political history, socio-economic history, cultural history deal with political, socio-economic and cultural developments respectively. The dates of birth, death, wars, administrative actions are significant for political historians. But historians studying other aspects like monuments or religious developments find other dates and events within the same time period more significant. Periodization in history. Periodization is the division of history into broad time periods on the basis of some distinctive characteristics. In 1817, James Mills, a Scottish philosopher, published a work, A History of British India. He divided Indian history into three broad periods on the basis of religion. He called the ancient period Hindu period because large parts of India was then under the Hindu rulers. Likewise, he called the medieval period Muslim period and the modern period British period. He thought that all the Asian societies were at lower level of civilization than Europe. Religious intolerance, caste taboos, and superstitious practices dominated social life. Mill felt that only British rule could civilize India, and so British should conquer all the territories in India to ensure enlightenment of Indian people. Moving away from the British classification, historians have divided Indian history into ancient, medieval and modern periods. It is a periodization which is borrowed from the West, where the modern period was associated with industrialization, scientific progress and urbanization. But the modern period of Indian history starts with the death of Aurangzeb, the Mughal emperor in 1707. The mighty Mughal empire was gradually disintegrating into a number of autonomous states while the British was rising in power. The 18th century was a period of political turmoil and economic stagnation in Indian history. The modern period of Indian history and that of European present a completely contrasting scenario. Trivia: the modern period of Indian history started in 18th century after the death of Aurangzeb, the Mughal emperor.